Hello, welcome to my channel once again. My name is Kamma Dyn and you're welcome. Today I am going to show you one video shows a lady who has lived in Uganda, and I think she's from Uganda, and she recently moved to Europe. And she has clearly seen the difference between Africa and Europe. And sometimes all I say is jobs is what perhaps is the difference between Africa and Europe, and bad leadership. But let's watch this video from this lady and come back and talk about it. And I'm also going to show you other videos that you need to see.
Since I moved to Sweden, I've been hearing Africa poor, Africa poor, Africa poor. How is it that a nation that lives under credit is calling Africa poor? Don't bash me, I'm gonna give you an example, okay? In Uganda, if you see someone walking around with an iPhone 12, they paid cash for it. If you see someone having a house, they built it cash. If you see someone driving a car, it's cash. Because in the world where I come from, if you don't have the money, then you can't buy. We don't have credit. Take example, Sweden. I can go to a shop, get an iPhone 12, credit. House, credit. Car, credit. Everything is credit. Even underwear, you can get it on credit. So technically, if you lose your job, you lose everything and you can go to the streets, okay? In Uganda, if you lose your job, you get to keep everything. You'll just worry, where am I gonna get money for school fees? Then it came to me, like, how the hell the people who live in credit call people who pay cash poor?
So you see, you people living abroad, that's in America, in Europe, most of you guys live on credit. They give your house is on credit, your rent is on credit, your phone is on credit. I mean, everything is on credit. So the moment you lose your job, everything is gone. The moment you lose your job, everything is gone. But in Africa, if you lose your job and through your job, you were able to build a house, it is only the job that you have lost, not your building. If you were able through your job to buy, if you were able through your job, bought a car or a vehicle, anything that you guys call it, you are only losing your job, not your car. You are going to only lose your job, not your phone. This is Africa. And sometimes you guys, I don't know, most of you still think Africa is poor. While you guys live on credit, we buy stuffs with cash. Listen, I'm going to show you another video or videos, and this is just cars. Cars that were bought with money. And this is just Ghana, or only Ghana, not the whole of Africa. I'm not showing you Nigeria, I'm not showing you South Africa, I'm not showing you Kenya, Tanzania, all the other African countries. This is only Ghana. Some few rich folks or Africans who have bought these type of cars that you know is some of the most expensive cars that you can ever buy abroad. And these cars, they are just driving these cars here like nobody's business. So if you think Africa is poor, rethink again. Let's watch these videos.
Good music from Kino DC. Kill it.
Min pen pen do. Min pen pen die. Ebiandara zimenye bibiara. Nansochi na zimenye bibiati. Namatoshe no. Namatoshe na mama mami o. Nansu watamfu no bado sa imo. Machina dami yo nyakuponi ba.
Chairman, happy birthday.
What's up?
Kamma Dyn.
So you see, these cars that I have shown you were bought with money, with cash, not credit. Nobody buys in Ghana. Maybe the government workers that sometimes they give out loans to them to buy whatever they want to buy, and they take it, or they deduct it from their salary every month. But let me tell you, most people in Africa don't live on credit. We buy with cash. If you see anybody using an iPhone 14 Pro Max or iPhone 14 or whatever, they bought it with cash. Thank you so much for watching this video.